Have you meant to start playing with AI, but just haven't gotten around to it yet? Hi, I'm Patti Scharf, CPA and partner at Acuity. Today, I'm going to be talking about all things artificial intelligence. I want to talk about custom GPT, assistants, and how third-party apps are bringing the benefits of AI to its customers. Okay, so this video is kind of a bonus video on the end of the automation series. I wasn't really going to talk about AI, but AI is so prevalent in what's going on in the accounting space and every other space in business that I felt like I would be remiss if I did not actually include some information about that. So today we're going to be talking about that. I am kind of a newbie to all this, so I will tell you what I have learned and hopefully push you in the right direction. But this should be good news for you because if I could pick it up quickly and easily, so can you. So let's get started. All right, I'm not going to go over the basics of ChatGPT. I'm going to jump straight into creating a custom GPT and then go from there. So hopefully you're on board with that. This came about because somebody on our team was using a custom GPT in the sales process. So they would meet with a client, they would download a transcript, they would run it through ChatGPT, this custom GPT that he made, and it would summarize everything, it would give him bullet points and do all the things that he wanted to do without having to get a separate tool, okay? When he brought this up to our leadership team, other people on the team were like, I would like something like that. And then he started sharing it with other people. We needed to get a team account to be able to share the GPTs. And that kind of led me here. One of the things that I wanted to do was build a custom GPT where anybody on our team could ask a question about Acuity and it would respond based on information that we had taught the system. So things like what our organizational chart is, what our HR policy is, what our IT policy is, and things like that. So I created what is called this Acuity Buddy. It is a custom GPT that I made, and you can see it gives you some suggested questions. How do I set up my company email? What's the dress code here? Things like that. And then if you go up here, I'm going to show you under the hood because I think this is where everybody gets kind of confused. Actually, before I do that, I'm going to show you over here. You're going to get there by going to My GPTs, okay? And then you can create a GPT straight from here. Just click on Create, and then it's going to ask you questions. So you just answer the questions and it will configure the bulk of it for you. That's what I did when I created it. It took me like 5 minutes, okay? So I'm going to show you under the hood what this looks like under configure. And basically you can name it, you can tell it what it's gonna do. Actually, ChatGPT filled in most of this for me. I just tweaked some things here or there. I put in the company's name just to kind of make it a little bit more clear and all of that. I think it pre-populated these questions based on what I told it I wanted it to do. But then here's the cool part. Under knowledge, I uploaded a whole bunch of PDFs that detailed the different information that we had from processes to just general standalone policies and information. And by importing all of that, now whenever anybody asks it a question, okay, and then I just wait and see what the answer is going to be. And it may or may not be accurate. So you need to pay attention to what's going on and then train it appropriately. So, and this is actually pretty decent. Okay, so that is the custom GPT. A few things that I will mention about this. Number one, I can use it all day long, but if I want to use it with somebody else on my team, then I need a team account. So the benefit of having a team account is that it's not going to use this information outside of your organization. So I know a lot of people worry about security with AI and training the large language models with company data, but that's not an issue on the team account. But once you have it, now you can share it between yourself and other people on your team, okay? The next thing I wanted to do was, once I had this, I was like, okay, great, but I only have like 10 or 20 people on our team account in OpenAI. Not everybody is going to be in here developing custom GPTs. So how do I use this GPT with other people on my team? So for example, how do I build this to work in Slack? And not surprisingly, Slack does not really make it super easy to create, to just embed this in their product, because they sell something called Slack AI. So they're going to be using, they want to push you to their paid product as opposed to doing something like this. However, you can use it. It's just, what I discovered is you can't use a custom GPT directly with Slack. You have to use OpenAI's API. So bear with me. I'm going to show you that in just a second. Okay, so the API is in a totally different place from where you just were with ChatGPT. They're kind of two subsets of the same company, okay? The API, when you log in, you're probably going to see something like this. If you're not a programmer, it may be a little bit scary. But if you go over to Playground and then go to Assistants, you're going to see what you're looking for, which is how to create an assistant. And once you get here, it's actually very similar to what you just did in Custom GPT. Now, the reason why you want to do this is because this speaks the same language as Slack. It speaks the same language as Zapier. It speaks the same language as Make. So if you are trying to tap into AI to do some things that you want to customize with other platforms and things like that, here's what you're going to use. So you just do the same thing. And actually, I'm going to show you the one that I built. And so this is the same basic custom GPT, only I created it in the API. So same name, same instructions. Here's where the files are. So these are the exact same files that I uploaded in the other one. And it basically does the same thing. It's just, you can tap into it now using those other third-party tools. I had to get my one of my teammates, JC, thank you, JC, to help me get this all the way into Slack. But if you're just a little bit tech savvy, just go into ChatGPT, say, how do I embed this into Slack? And it'll give you instructions on how to do it, okay? Now, once I knew that and I saw that this worked, so basically now anybody on our team can go into Slack and type /ask the question, and it will run through this custom GPT for them and answer their questions. Yay. But once I knew how that worked, then I started wondering how all of the other apps that we're using are integrating AI into their systems. So that's what I'm going to talk about next. Okay, so this is process.st. I've talked about process.st. in the past. You can check out a video here. And they have AI functionality embedded within their product. So they've got this AI task here. So after you enter some information, you enter some more information, you mark those as done, it's going to run AI. Actually, let me just show you really quickly. So I have some default information for these fields here. I can overwrite them and say whatever I want to and mark that as done. Tell me which platforms. Let's just do YouTube. Actually, let's do TikTok too. And when I mark this as done, you'll see it's going to run through AI and it's going to spit out the answer in the next step. voila. So there's all the information. You can kind of use it or copy and paste or whatever. It's got tags and all the different stuff. So as I was thinking about how this works, and I was looking at what you need to plug in there, it occurred to me, oh, they're probably using something like Assistants, where it's kind of pre-scripted, and then they ask you for the inputs in the workflow, and then the AI works under the hood and spits out the answer. When I reached out to Process.st, I was specifically asking about security. I want to make sure that the information that's being taken in here isn't being used in a large language model that is going to jeopardize the security of our company or anything like that. And they said, no, they use OpenAI's API. So they literally are using assistants to do this. They have some pre-scripted stuff and they are keeping the information secure. So one other thing I will mention, they said that not only is the information not shared publicly, but it's also unique to this specific workflow. So it's not even shared organization-wide. So that's just good information to have. But it was interesting to see how other companies' third-party apps are using AI in their products, and this is how they came to market so quickly. If you look at Amazon, they are summarizing the reviews. If you are looking at Google, they are summarizing, I mean, they're probably using Gemini because they're Google, but you know what I mean? Like, all these different apps are using AI that already exists somewhere else. So as long as we can figure out how to tap into it and build it for our own custom use, it's going to help us be more efficient and help our customers as well. So I guess that's it. I hope this made AI a little bit more accessible to you. I hope you like this video. If you did, please like, comment, and share. If you haven't already, please subscribe. And I'll catch you later.